2. This is George with the Cross Country Mission. How's everyone doing tonight? I certainly hope you're doing well. I just got a little story to share. I know I haven't been on here for a whole minute, but I got a little story to share with you. You know, I got all my stuff moved this weekend, so my wife and my daughter's already up there. She's on spring break down in Springfield right now. They're cleaning up the house down there. But anyways, that's not my story. My story is, so I got all the stuff out of the U-Haul today, and I'm running around, I'm cleaning up my truck, getting it all ready for work that I haven't done in like a year, you know. I just procrastinating, and the truck just needed cleaned out, so I did that and went and gave it a bath. You know, we had three nice days of weather in a row. I don't know what the deal was, but you know, I walked out this morning, you could see, you know, the silver lining in the sky where you knew it was just going to be a cloudy day this afternoon. Anyways, that's not the story either. So I go up to get a haircut, thus the messed up hair. But I go up to Fantastic Sam's, this place I always go, and they was closed. They're closed on Tuesdays. Well, I just left Walmart, and I thought, well, you know, I'm not really that big of a fan of Walmart haircutting place, but I did notice when I was there 5 minutes prior to this that there was nobody there. So I go back over to Walmart, right? And I go back in there, like, hey, can you guys get me in? She's like, yeah. She looks back there, and the one girl with the multicolored rainbow hair or whatever, she was just getting off. But the other girl's back there, she was working on some other girl. You know, had aluminum foil all in the hair like this and stuff. You know, I tell you something, like, oh, all foiled up and nowhere to go, eh? And the girl with the foil in her hair was a born-again Christian, and she was working over this girl, this beautician, right? And this haircutting, for I'll just call her beautician for lack of better words. She was trying to talk to her about Jesus and stuff. Well, when I sit down, I don't know how I got pulled into the conversation, but next thing we know, I'm listening to this girl with the foil in her hair talking. She's talking. Oh, she's awake, you know. I mean, she's born again Christian. She knows what's going on. She's on the same road that I've been on. She's all the way down to the smoking. You know, she hasn't quit smoking yet, but she's pretty wise to the book. You know, she's on to Genesis, all over the New Testament, all over the Nephilim, all over the giants begotten sex with our women and had these giant babies, or the fallen angels, you know, had sex with our women, had these giants. I'm like, oh, I says, you could tell by the way she was talking, she had read the book of Enoch as well. Now, I know it ain't part of our Bible, but it used to be, and they took it out. But anyways, if you've never read the book of Enoch, it's a pretty interesting read. It explains a lot of things. You know, there's only two people in the Bible that never died, and that is Enoch and Elijah. Elijah was taken in Kings, in the first Kings, I think. I forget what area. But anyways, God took Elijah, and Enoch is the seventh from Adam, the great-grandfather of Noah. He lived, I think, 365 years, and then God took him, and he was not, for Enoch walked with God, is what it says. So anyways, just by the way she was talking, I knew that she was talking about the book of Enoch. So I had a chance. There was this chance, this window of opportunity, and I wouldn't even be there if the place where I went wasn't closed, right? So it's just like God just put me right here to witness to this girl. And I'm a pretty good listener these days, so I was listening to what she was saying, and I caught that she had been doing yoga and, you know, meditating. And well, this normally goes with the New Age religion, right? And I had a little dabble in that myself. I was meditating, and I had this experience with this guy named Billy Myers. He said he claims to have been in contact with people from the star system Pleiades since he was 5 years old. The guy's like probably 80 years old. I believe he's still alive. He was as of a couple years ago. But I remember when I was into all that, it's like Billy Myers, he had this list of people. I mean, witnesses, right? We're talking 2 pages of witnesses. These people witnessed the starships coming in. They would see him. They witnessed Billy leaving one day, clean shaven, coming back a day later, and had at least a 4 days worth of growth of beard. And this is when Billy was jumping time, you know, going back to to meet Jesus on one of his trips. He met Emmanuel, right? And it just blah blah blah. It's just so amazing. I remember when I was up on the slope up in North Alaska. I was up there in the slope, and I'd made a statement to somebody, because I mean I was in it deep, you know, and I believed it, you know. And she's like, "Well, you ought to be a salesperson for this stuff, you know." And I made a statement. I says, "You know," I says, "well, if I believe it, I can sell it." And that's just what it, and that's just the way it is. You know, I mean, if I believe it, God's given me a pretty strong voice, and you know, I can get people's attention. Well, I told her that story, but with this added on to it, because I wanted her to see that I had touched that side of the religious thing. And then I told her, you know, that after all that, there was just this little something going on in my head, and all of a sudden I felt like Jesus was saying, "Well, George, what about my witnesses?" You know, and I thought, God, you know, you say God or Jesus, but God is like, "Well, what about my son Jesus? Huh? You ever checked him out? What about my witnesses? What about my book?" And I'm like, "Oh, yeah." So anyways, I was telling her this story, and it was just, it was an amazing, amazing haircut. And I told her, you know, I told her about that time, January of 2018, like the last time the Lord showed up when I was down in Illinois. You know, I was driving down the road, and I'd already, you know, got rid of the womanizing thing. That's the first thing the Lord took. I told her about that, and how my eyes always used to wander to everything except my wife, you know. And it was terrible. It was terrible. What a way to, you know, and it wasn't fair to my wife. And anyways, but I told her about that and how the Lord took that. And then the drinking thing, you know, how I'd been an alcoholic for like 30 plus years and I couldn't do it. And it wasn't until I admitted defeat and went to the Lord and asked him to take it, did he take it? And the same with the smoking. And then in December of, or January of 2018, I explained to her about what happens when the Lord shows up. And I told her, I says, you know, I was driving down the road there in Ardmore, Oklahoma on I-35 South heading towards Dallas. I said, I was down there working. I said, I was listening to Derek Prince. He was doing a mass deliverance thing, you know, on YouTube. And I'd been chasing the Lord really hard at that time. I said, and the way it come, I said, I was just driving down a road, you know, and I had my hand up and I was just talking to God. I was kind of repeating what Derek had to say, you know, with regards to these demons. And I felt I'd met all the conditions to be delivered from any other demons or dark things that was, you know, dark corners of my life and whatnot, you know. And I explained it to her, and it really did happen just this way, you know. I mean, I was driving down a road like this, you know, and all of a sudden it just, I started coughing a little bit, you know. Next thing you know, you know, it just right through the roof of my truck. I mean, here just comes the Lord. He's like, woof, just like right here. I mean, if I would have been outside my truck, I would have fell on the ground. The presence was that strong. And I just, snot just started running down my nose. I'm just, you know, it's a hacking. Like everything that was remotely even dark, man, it was running, you know, because the light come in. There can't be no darkness in the light. The darkness runs from the light. It's like, and I told her, I said, well, check it out. I says, when you go to the bathroom at night, I says, you turn on the light. I says, what happens? I says, all the darkness goes, doesn't it? Because the light's there. So it can't be, no, darkness can't exist in the light. But the light can come into the darkness. The darkness just can't go into the light. Maybe if there's a little shady spot, you shine a little light there. Hey, that darkness runs too. Anyways, by the time it's all said and done, man, you know, that girl's up there, she's almost dropping tears a little bit, you know. She's like, you know, I got up and I gave her a hug, you know, a big hug, and I says, you know, I says, the funny thing about the Lord, I says, he loves you more than your mom and daddy loves you. I said, he just does. And I says, when he shows up, I said, he got the power, and he does have the power, just in case you don't know this. He can stop the entire universe. We're talking the stars from flickering, cars from driving down the road, lights from coming on, going out, wars from happening. He stops everything to come and see you and tell you that he loves you. That's what he does. That's the power of the Lord that I serve. And it was just an awesome witness thing. I guarantee you, I know for a fact that woman's life is going to change. And the Lord put me right there at that time today to to tell her that he loves her. And, you know, I explained to her like this, because I don't know how else to explain it, you know. I says, imagine this. I said, imagine that you was the last baby ever to be born on earth. I believe I've used this before if anyone's watched, you know, my channels, and there's a few of us that do. I says, you're the last baby to be born on the entire earth, and every mother on the entire earth was at your birth. And every mother on the entire earth passed you around and just loved you. I says, imagine how great that love would be. She's like, oh yeah. I says, don't even compare to Jesus' love. Don't even compare to the love of God. I says, he loves you. And I says, I tell you what, I says, if you look for him, if you search him, you chase him. I says, you remember them boys you used to chase when you was a teenager boy? You just go after him. She gets all blushed. She's like, yeah, yeah, yeah. I said, chase Jesus in the same manner. I said, he will show up. I says, I promise you. And I looked at her, I says, Jesus. I says, you heard me. I said, I just promised you that you're going to show up. I said, you know. But anyways, gave her a big hug, you know, and told her the Lord loved her and tried to pay for my haircut. She's like, oh no, you ain't going to pay for that haircut. Not today. She's, I thank you so much. She's, I just, you know, something's just missing. I don't know what it is. I said, it's the Lord that's missing, honey. It's the Lord that's missing. Anyways, that story was just such an awesome experience for me today. It's just, it's hard for me to keep things like that to myself. When they happen to me, I just want to share the goodness of God with you. Hey, look, remember here a while back I showed you I was zero balance on my crosses? Look at all these crosses. I'm making them. I told Daddy, I says, man, my dad, I said, I'd like to get like 100 of these bad boys made and take like a week or two off work and just take off with that big cross. That's what I really want to do. Before we even buy another house, I might talk to my wife and my daughter and everything and talk to my work, see if I can't get off, you know, a little bit of time, maybe with God willing. Hey, you know, I haven't been saying that we're going to move down here. I've been saying it like they say in James. I think it's James. You know, he says, why do you worry about tomorrow? Why do you say that we're going to move to this city or that city? And we're going to make money here, or make money there. Well, you don't even know what you're going to do tomorrow. Instead, you should say, if it's the Lord's will, this is what we're going to do. And that's what I've been saying, you know, since all this has been going on. You know, it was my plan, but if it's the Lord's will, them girls are going to follow me up here, me and my wife and my daughter. And apparently it is the Lord's will. And I think he's happy that I'm bearing some kind of fruit, you know. Maybe not as good as Billy Graham or as good as others, but I sure love him. And I think he knows that I love him. And I love him for using me. Anyways, I love you. And Jesus loves you too. So I hope that story is just inspiring towards you. Maybe if you're just on the fence and sometimes you want to share with somebody, but you're just a little nervous too, or you don't know how they're going to take it. Shh, man, let it all go. Just let it all go. Blessed is he who is, you know, shamed because of the Lord. Don't worry about none of that. Just know that he loves you and he's proud of you for everything you do. And he's going to use you. If he's not using you now, he may not be proud of everything you do, but he's going to use you. And he loves you. And I love you. And this is George with the Cross Country Mission. I hope that this message finds you in a lovely state of mind and that it blesses you. I'll talk to you later. Thanks for listening. Bye-bye.